just the whole atmosphere of the place, the coming here. We had came from Dundas District, and the school opened in 1960, and we came. Yep.
Beating Ancaster 37-0 in a senior football game.
I don't know, the Friday Nighters Club down here, that was fun. What was that here? Oh, you basically leaned on the wall and watched everybody dance.
No, every, like a first Friday in every month or something.
That might have been Dundana. Like I said, my memory is not good.
We are completely overwhelmed and overjoyed with what has transpired. We were concerned even just a few weeks ago about the numbers, and the momentum really picked up in the last couple of weeks. So we're really, really pleased to see the turnout both at the Friday night welcome back pub and at the Saturday night dance and bash. So we're just overjoyed, just thrilled. We've had graduates come from all over the world, from Hong Kong, Singapore, British Columbia, California, Boston. And I just learned this over the last few days and during the weekend's events, how far some people have come that I didn't know were coming from that far. You said no strings could secure you at the station.
This has been awesome. This has been the greatest weekend. I've had a pleasure. It's been almost 30 years. Friends that, you know, you've lost track over the years after you leave high school. But now with the beauty of technology and computers, managed to reconnect and hook up with a lot of old friends that I've lost touch with. And this has just been very overwhelming and humbling, to say the least. It's nice to see that the faces that we once knew when we were in high school have not changed.
After seeing all these people who are so appreciative of what Parkside was for them in the day, I'm developing more of an appreciation for my days at high school.
Just a fantastic reunion. Commend everybody that put it on. I mean, walking through that tent on Friday night and seeing all those smiling faces just glowing, people walking around and around and around in circles, seeing all the friends and everything are just fantastic performance everybody put on, and it's just a great job everybody did. Back to
one memory that I'll always have is of the team that won the OFSA championship back then. I wasn't actually on the team, but I was a manager of the team, and it will be forever ingrained. I can remember jumping, in fact I'm reliving that now, jumping as high as you could when that last basket went in and we won the OFSA championship. It was a really big deal at that time, as it was this year when our team won again.
Hasn't changed at all. Still the big old wooden desks. I mean, I went into the change room to use the bathroom, and still the lockers are still the same, and you know, just brought back some really fond memories. Took a trip down the science hallway and just was like, wow, I cannot believe that, you know, this is the school is still the same. So I'd like to say a big thank you, especially to Dean. This weekend was amazing. I had a lot of fun, even though there wasn't a lot of people there from the 90s. It was still good to get on out. You know, it's been almost 15 years since I've been out of high school now. I hate to say that because I don't want to tell everyone how old I am. But yeah, no, great, big thanks. I just wish there was more people from our decade here, but had a blast and really enjoyed myself. It was very well put together.
It doesn't matter how much effort, how much work it feels like, it all pays off when you see everybody and enjoying themselves and making connections they have made for years and all that sort of thing.
a list of Parkside Panther basketball players that have played in the NCIS. We were fortunate enough to win the gold medal for Austin boys basketball. One of several Austin medalists at Parkside, and so here's the list. 1974 boys.
I'll start with a song about remembering. Since I couldn't remember half the people I met this time, I'd talk to somebody for half an hour, walk away and say, who the hell was that anyway? I'm looking for my wallet and my car keys. They can't have gone too far. I find my glasses, I'm sure I'll see right where they are. I'm supposed to meet someone for lunch today, but I can't remember where or who it is.
the cards. Cut the cards.
Ready?
Hey, not bad, huh?
Great.
Here, do me a favor. Shuffle the cards for me.
Shuffle them?
Shuffle them right up. I'll bet you everything in my wallet that that I find your card. Nice. One, two, three. Oh, that wasn't it.
Whoopsie.
It's one chance. That's it. That's all I get. Look. Look, can you see in my wallet? Can you see there's a zipper part there? Can you see it's open though?
Yeah.
Can you reach inside? See anything in there?
Oh my God. Oh.
Can you open that up?
Oh, get out of town. Shut the front door.
That's for you.
I'd like to thank Dean Cowell and the whole group of people, the volunteers, to put this together. It was an excellent weekend. The Friday night was awesome. Saturday night was, and you know, the sports activities on Saturday, getting to play basketball and volleyball again. That was excellent. And just the whole weekend, all the work and hours that were put into it, just appreciated by us able to attend and, you know, meet up with people that we haven't seen for many years in our case. And just want to say thank you. And hello again to everybody that participated. Your eyes, girl, look inside, girl, let the sound take you away.
Last night I hold a letter slam. I had some wonderful moments as an athlete at Parkside as well, in running and track and so on. But that I think probably really stands out. And then my last year as student council president was a blast too. We just had a ton of fun. And somebody was disappointed because we had a Let's Do It campaign and everybody was talking about that for a long time. And then we had another one that everybody was catching on to, and I didn't get to say it this weekend. And everybody's looking forward to me saying, yo, nobody will get that. But anyway, anybody that's from 77 will understand what that meant.
Okay.
I know, I can't help it. First of all, I have to thank the committee. I wasn't even involved in the first couple of meetings, so it was already started and underway when I got involved. And there are people here in the committee that were on the 25th anniversary committee as well, so again, they're dedicated too. But we started meeting in April last year, so it's been a year and a bit of meeting every other week or so, and doing lots of planning, having lots of discussions about all the decisions we're making. And there was that core committee, and then there were a ton of people that were really involved in and around that committee. And many volunteers as well from the school. We had over 50 or 60 student volunteers, as well as many adult volunteers came out to help. So it was just a huge, big thank you to all those people.